channel and it's Mimi Nataram and Dinesh. I hope you are fine. And today we are going to see about verb. So for a human body, both head and body is equally important. So in the same way, for a sentence, subject and verb both are important, equally important. So without a verb, a sentence cannot get a fulfilled content, meaning and all that. So without a verb, there won't be any sentence at all. So that much important is verb. So let's see about the verb and what are the things which is hidden inside the verb. So just take a look here. So first of all, what is a verb? That is a word that describes an action. Most of you know that verb is an action. It describes about the action, that is what the doer is doing. So that is said to be the verb. So verb, there are the three parts. So that is, the first one is a physical action, the second one is mental action, the third one is a state of being. So physical action means it represents all the things which we are doing physically, that is swimming, eating, sleeping and drinking. So it is all physical action. And mental action represents which we things do mentally, that is without our hands, legs, with things which we do mentally. So that is said to be mental action. That is a think, guessing, dreaming. So it is all about mental action. And the third one is a state of being. So the state of being is like how you are being, existing and we are appearing. So if you see an example, you will be getting a clear view about all these three actions. So first, let's take about physical action. So see, look at the example here I have given. I teach you English. So we went to the market. So here, teach and went. So both are physical action. And these two are actions here. So this is said to be verb. And these two things are done by physical part. So it is said to be physical action. And the next thing is mental action. So here, look at the example. I know the answer and I desire to go to the Ooty. So here, know and desire both are verb. And both is the know and desire. Both actions are done through our mind, not physically, without our legs and hands. We have done this with our mind only. So this is said to be mental action. And the next one is a state of being. That is, here it represents all the auxiliary verbs, that is helping verbs like is, are, am, was, have. So all that will be coming under this. So look at the example here. It is cool, we are happy, I am a boy. So in these sentences, there is no main verb. All these verbs are helping verbs, that is auxiliary verbs. So if you have a sentence with the help of this auxiliary verb, that is said to be a state of being. And finally, and there are two types of verbs, that is transitive and intransitive. Hope you all seen the last video about this transitive and intransitive. Hope you guys understood this verb. And I'll catch you in the next class. And then it's Mimi Nataram signing off. Bye bye. See ya. Take care.